I'm totally like, I'm doing something with that. I'm keeping it.
Yeah. Did that fuck up the recording?
No, it killed it. It saved it as a different audio file, and now we got a new one. So
we're nice.
So. I don't know.
You think?
I'm a little tired. I didn't sleep well, but I got coffee, so I'm good.
Welcome to the Awkward Silence podcast, where it's full ASMR all the time. This is the sound of a microphone against a beard.
It's the sound of two tired guys. Exactly.
We were up all night waiting for the Testament album, and only one of us got a chance to listen to it. It was me.
How was it?
I'm only like halfway through it, but spoiler alert, it's fucking
awesome. How did you get halfway through an album?
Well, because I didn't listen to it last night. I woke up this morning and I downloaded it on Spotify. Uh-huh. And then I had class, so I listened to it on the way to class and on the way back from class. And then I had to do this, so good job.
Wait, how? What? On the way to class and the way back to class?
Yeah.
Like,
what do you mean?
I thought you lived on campus now.
I do, but it's still quite a walk.
Like,
I live on the other side. Where the dorms are is the other side of campus is where all my classes are, so I have to hike it every day. It sucks.
Oh. That's weird.
You have no fucking idea. The winter snuck up on us yesterday. Like, it went from... When we got here, it was August, and it was fucking blistering out. Our dorms don't have air conditioning. It fucking sucked.
Jeez.
Oh, yeah, it was abysmal. But October rolls around, and, like, you know, it's starting to cool down a bit. Yesterday, it was snowing, and it was windy, and there was ice on this fucking bridge that I have to walk on to get to class. I almost fucking killed myself.
Nice.
I didn't have any gloves. I forgot to bring them. No one was prepared for it. I was walking behind these two guys, and they each had umbrellas, and then at one point, like, they just stopped and they started yelling, like, oh my god, our umbrellas broke because of the snow. It's fucked.
What?
Sandpaper just being slapped in your
face. How do umbrellas break because of snow?
Because the wind was so fast that the snow was turning into ice. It was pelting ice at people. It was fucking awful.
Also, why would you burn umbrellas?
I don't know, because they didn't want to get snow on them?
What? It was clearly really fucking windy, was it not?
Yes, it was also really snowy.
Yeah, why would you take an umbrella in a windy place?
I didn't judge them. They were smarter than me. I didn't have any gloves or anything. And I have to carry shit, so my hands were exposed. It was awful.
How's that frostbite treating you?
I know it's doing murder on my hands. Billy, you should be wearing mittens. Do you not remember that bit from Billy and Mandy?
Oh, God.
Where Billy was whipping garden gnomes for some reason in the winter?
That's... Oh, God, I can't remember that part.
It's the one where Nurgle comes to stay for, like, forever. It's one of my favorites because he walks in. It's like you gotta tell Nurgle to get out of your house. And he walks in and Nurgle's sitting by a fire. And then Billy just starts crying. And he goes, "That's not a fireplace. That's my new video game console."
Okay, I vaguely remember that joke.
Yeah, you just see like an N64 on fire. It's great.
Fucking Billy with a fucking N64. What a fucking hipster.
Of course he is. What was this, like 2003?
Yeah.
Get on it. Get on your. What was it? The Virtual Boy.
What? Why is the Virtual Boy the first thing you went to?
Because the Virtual Boy is awesome.
Why not GameCube?
It's not. I don't know. How about the Phantom?
The what?
The Phantom.
What?
The console that never came out. The game.com.
Don't know what this is.
Do you not know about all these terrible consoles that never came out? Oh, I love it. There's the game.com, There's the Phantom, also never came out, which is amazing. What was that one that was like funded by the Russian?
What?
No. Listen, I will Google this right now. Hold on a sec.
The fuck are you talking about?
Oh yeah, here it is. Google the Gizmodo. Oh, Gizmondo. Excuse me. Gizmondo. It was a handheld console from Tiger Electronics, and apparently has connections to the Russian mob.
What the fuck?
I don't know. But it wasn't good. It came out. It was out in stores for like a week or something. Its best-selling game was something called Sticky Balls.
Nice.
Oh, it was released in March of 2005 and was cut on February of 2006, so like a year.
Like not even a year.
Like barely a year. Man, that Sticky Balls game is weird, though.
The first image on Google Images just has a skull on the screen.
Good job. Of course it would. That thing is weird. I remember seeing...
What the fuck are those buttons?
I know. Yeah.
Why?
I saw a game trailer's top 10 a long time ago, and it had a bunch of these on it. Like, these awful consoles that never existed or discontinued real quick. This was one of them. This was number 1, actually, because not only was it terrible, but it had mob connections. Oh, wow. Then there's the Jaguar, which was a cool name, but...
That is a cool name.
Guess what? It was terrible. It had, like, a really good Alien game on it, though.
Yeah. I don't know. Dude.
Was the Neo Geo good? Can anyone tell me that?
Probably, I think.
I mean, if it only existed to play, Metal Slug, like, I can get behind that. Fucking love Metal Slug.
And also all the other SNK games.
Oh, yeah. Like.
Fighters.
Yeah. I need more fighting games.
So if there's a console called the Jaguar, then is there a rival console called the Red Dragon?
Been working on that one all day?
I've worked on that for exactly 17 seconds.
Good job.
Thanks.
Okay, I just Googled Red Dragon. I'm getting pictures of the actual Red Dragons. This is not working.
Red Dragon!
Gersh, bersh, gersh. Alright, so should we talk about, like, something else now?
Let's talk about the album that you have listened to.
Shut up, Alec. I know what I'm doing. I'm talking through a microphone. Because my other microphone is shit. It's my friend Dakota back home.
Hello.
It's a long story how I got here.
Oh, really?
Googling Red Dragons.
As long as it's not Bad Dragon, I think we're okay.
No.
The opposite. As long as it's Bad Dragon, we are okay.
No, see, Bad Dragon...
What's your favorite?
My favorite what?
What's your favorite Bad Dragon?
He wants to know what our favorite Bad Dragon is.
Yes. There is no wrong answer.
I saw one called the Sphincter Punch the other day. I thought it looked cool.
As Brian would say, the tongue punch of the fart box.
The tongue punch. That was my roommate Alec. He's super Jewish. Alec, if there was a Jewish superhero, what would your symbol be?
What would my symbol be?
Yeah.
Obviously a dollar sign.
Did you hear that one?
Yeah.
It says a dollar sign.
Yeah, it's Christ.
Did you know that Marvel?
No, the opposite of Christ.
I could throw an upside down cross on there. Although, I wouldn't want to give people the wrong image.
Would you be like Batman? You'd have like the Star of David as your like throwing stars as your batarangs? Little ones?
You know what?
Those would hurt someone.
If I was thinking about throwables, it would be a small bag of money. Filled with very heavy coins. And I just toss them at people.
They'd be like grenades. You throw them at people and it hurts them. But then it distracts them because there's money all over the ground now.
Right.
know what I was going to say? Marvel in the 80s made a bunch of really racist villains.
No, I did not know that,
one
but I wanted
them
to know.
One of them was called, it was a Jewish accountant. His super villain name was Moneybags.
Oh my god.
And his power was shooting coins at his.
That doesn't sound real. Hold on. I'm Googling that.
I'm pretty sure.
That sounds pretty real. I can imagine that.
Jewish accountant jokes. Yep, there we go.
There's a bunch of shit that I'm pretty sure Marvel has been erasing from, like, history.
Oh, I'm sure they're doing that.
Like, you know how, like, a few months ago there was that whole deal with, like, Captain America being a Nazi?
What? Being a Nazi? You mean being a Hydra agent?
Yeah, whatever.
No, it's a bit of a misnomer there, Dakota, that there's a big difference between being a Hydra agent and a Nazi, except for that one time.
I don't know comics. I don't read cape shit.
I'm just saying, you're kind of close. I mean, in the Captain America movie, like, Red Skull and Hydra were Nazis, so...
Anyways, though, you know what I mean.
I know what you mean.
But, like, someone actually did that before, and, like, this was while the original guys that made Captain America were still working at Marvel, and... Like, they wrote a comic about Captain America being a Nazi just to fucking spite them.
Nice. That's
and,
awesome.
Like, this was, like, completely redacted from fucking everything.
Oh, here we go.
Oh, okay. Hold on.
No,
we might have just found it. I was going to say, Alec, maybe this is some weird Nazi propaganda that you just, like, internalized. Absolutely. Are we getting a squirrel?
Almighty Dollar.
His name's Almighty Dollar.
That was it.
That is crazy.
That's a fucking name.
That's a cool name, though.
Dude has some power. Shoot pennies from his hands.
The ability to shoot pennies from his hands.
His real name was Pennington Pennypacker.
Pennington Pennypacker! I love that!
They don't go into it, but he was a Jewish accountant.
Okay, that's awesome.
I don't know how he got his powers, but that was the image that I was shown.
So, he just shoots coins out of his hands.
No, pennies. Not even coins. Jewish accountant.
That is amazing.
Almighty.
That is awesome. Oh, I'm going to have to look at this list later. Like, this is amazing. It's like the 27 worst superheroes. And it's like, here's Bouncing Boy and Fiddler Man.
Link me that shit, yo.
Yeah, I will. All right, we got sidetracked pretty hard there.
Yeah. Though we were kind of itching for a topic anyways. Mm-hmm.
What did I do with my week? Thanks for asking.
Yeah.
So, basically, short version of it is I'm in college.
Sweet-o.
Same shit, different day. I listened to the new Green Day album, Revolution Radio.
Oh, boy.
All right, listen to me very carefully on this one. All the Green Day fans out there who really like this album, you need to stop. It wasn't good. I came away from this album... feeling nothing, and it was kind of a bummer, because I just, like, I don't have a solid opinion on it. I listened to the album and I went, that was all right, and then I listened to it again and again and again. I've listened to this a bunch of times. I have some emotion. I just don't know what it is. It's a mixture of, like, confusion and disappointment, because it's not good. I know that Green Day songwriting has not been at the top of its game, but it's so painfully fucking obvious now. Take one look. I'm going to send you something. These are the lyrics to a song called Youngblood from that album. These lyrics are... I would call them shitposting, but, like... It's stuff that the... Death Grips would look at and be like, this is just fun, stupid.
So what you're saying is, it's just another Green Day album,
get
then.
Get shit on, you motherfucker. No, but here's the thing, though. I will tell you this. As much as I know that people don't like Green Day now, and maybe never have, like, listen, shut up.
at least musically, they try on every album. There is a solid difference between every single Green Day album. I can tell you that for a certain. There's a huge difference between American Idiot and 21st Century. There's a big difference between 21st Century and the trilogy albums. This is nothing. Like, I felt nothing. There is nothing. It's not good. Yeah. But I really like the song Somewhere Now on there. It's really good.
Supernova Cherry Cola.
I know, look at that shit.
Cedar in the trees of Minnesota. What is this garbage?
It's such garbage. It's so bad. But here's the thing, is that when you hear it in the song, though, it's kind of catchy. I mean, it's... Oh, it's bad, but I had fun listening to it.
What do you say?
I think my favorite line is at the bottom, is in verse 2. It says, "Are you broken? Like I'm broken. Are you restless? She said, fuck you, I'm from Oakland." Like, what the fuck am I looking at?
What does that mean?
I don't know. They're from Oakland, Green Day. They're from California. I don't know. And I just want to say this on this. Why do Mike Dirnt and Trey Cool not want to do anything on these albums? It is fucking annoying now. They're the drummer and the bassist. They are very talented people.
There's a human being named Mike Dirt.
Yeah.
Nice.
Well, his last name is something else, but he calls himself Dirt because when he used to play air bass, he would make the sound Dirt, Dirt, Dirt to play bass.
Oh.
I know, it's fucking lame. But, see, they're actually super talented people, and on these albums they are just doing nothing, and I don't know why. They play along, and it's just, that's it. We're done for the day.
They're like Gary Holt on Slayer.
Don't even get me started. But, yeah, that's the new Green Day album. It's nothing. I listened to the new Blink-182.
Check this out. Oh, it's fucking nothing!
Oh, look, I what is this I have in my pocket? Oh, it's a bunch of nothing. Good job. That sounds like a Tyranny of Tradition article. Green Day puts out an album, and it's just 90 minutes of silence.
Yeah.
I would listen to that still. I'd still buy it just to say I own it. I know, I'm a whore. I have a problem.
You would.
Yeah, I would. So, guess what else I listen to?
What?
The new Blink-182 album, California.
Why do you do this to yourself?
Because I'm a child. I don't know. So, Blink-182 has this real problem where they make albums with, like, 3 or 4 really solid tracks and, like, 12 more songs of nothing. And this one's no different. Except everyone's real bitchy about this one because Matt Skiba is replacing Tom DeLonge. I also feel nothing about this
vocalists?
Album. Yeah. You know when you listen to Blink-182 and you hear the whiny guy? That's Tom DeLonge.
Does this guy sound any better?
He sounds much better than Tom DeLonge. Like, his voice isn't as original, mind you, but it's better. Original does not mean good.
True.
He's just a punk vocalist. It's fine. He does a good job. But this album just sounds boring. The only one with any talent anymore is Travis. Travis Barker. His drums are amazing.
Hey, Jake, what's up?
I have a question.
What's up?
Is that a microphone?
Yes, it is.
Okay.
No, it's a dick. What did you think it was, Jake? I just have a severed penis. I'm just talking into it now.
I don't know what the fuck you're doing in here.
I'm masturbating in the common room. What the fuck do you think I'm doing?
Hey, don't let me try it.
Jesus Christ, Jake.
I'm so honored that you would be masturbating to me.
I'm not masturbating to you. I just happen to be masturbating in front of you.
Oh.
You just happen to be in the audience. You're the audience. The audience I need. Okay. Where was I?
Where were you? You were talking about Blink-182.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I went to see Blink-182 with my roommates when we first got here. It was fucking cool. Because, like, we just happened to see, Blink-182 is playing. You guys want to go? And road trip time. That was all right. It was pretty good. They're way better live, honestly. Yeah. It's a real bummer that, like, all these nice pop punk bands are coming back, except for Sum 41, fuck them. And they're turning out such trash. At least Green Day is consistent with how trash they are. I know what I said.
I'm gonna quote that.
They consistently put out trash. It's fine. Consistency.
You're talking shit about me not liking Green Day. I'll just say, hey, Green Day consistently puts out trash.
No, listen, they do, though. They do. And you know what? I'm at the bottom of the trash heap. I'm just like, hey, just load the trash on me. Just toss it over. Make a pyramid out of my trash.
You empty the trash out.
Onto my face.
So you can crawl to the bottom and get the first taste of the new trash.
The first taste of new trash. I love it. That's the brand new flavor coming from Coca-Cola. Fresh trash. Oh, yeah, and I put out an EP on SoundCloud called Grind Snore if you want to go listen to it.
Oh, yeah, check it out. I did an album cover.
He did the album cover and he helped me with vocals. That was so much fun to listen to again, like, because we did it back in August, and I was been sitting on it for a while, and I finally listened to it again. I was like, is this any good? It's pretty funny. It's one of the it's one of my favorite things I've ever done, at least.
Yeah, it was kind of shit.
No, it's shit in the fun way. It's like Texas Toast when they make a dumb song.
Yeah, but I didn't even do it good.
No, you did, though. You did fine. Shut up.
Did you hear all the distortion and effects I put over my vocals because I can't growl?
Shut up and take the compliment.
I refuse.
Good job. So what did you do with your life for the last 6 months?
Die.
Oh. And... You seem to have been recovering pretty well.
Yeah. I got my skin back.
So you had your skin off at one point.
Well, yeah.
I mean, I should have known. I mean, how else does anyone else die? I mean, skin off, that's all. That's the only way anyone dies anymore.
Skin off, skin on. It's like I'm two people.
Sure.
Did you not remember that?
No. What are you talking about?
Glasses on, glasses off. It's like I'm two people.
I don't know what you're referring to. What the hell?
Have you ever tried to fuck a box?
God damn it. It came back to haunt me. I haven't shown those to my friends yet. I'm going to have to show it to them.
Dude, after we're fucking done,
yes.
You gotta.
I'm going to. They already think that I have the worst sense of humor.
I mean, you kind of do.
I know. But, okay, get this. The first day that we're here, we're all just sitting around eating lunch together. And Alec tells us, oh, by the way, I'm Jewish, but don't make a big deal out of it. I make more Holocaust jokes than anybody. And then I go, well, I would make jokes about the Holocaust if it actually happened. And that pretty much set the tone for everything that would follow.
Nice!
You have no idea. They have a running book of me. They call it the Book of Eric. It's out of context. Ah!
What?
Don't worry about it. It's out of context shit that they've been saying about me, or that I've been saying for the past 4 months or so.
Oh, God, I need to read this book.
I will send you. Send me the list. My friend wants to read it. What? The Book of Eric. It's like a Google Doc. They each got a part, and I don't have it. It's been fun. All right, so after you died, what else did you do? Any new music? Any new art that you want to plug?
Here's the thing.
don't know if you know about my music habits.
It's pretty trash.
Yeah, kind of.
Yeah, speaking of trash heaps.
What I do is whenever I need to listen to music, like when I'm drawing or whatever, I'll consider trying to find something else, but then I'll go to YouTube and just click and just listen to whatever album is in my, like, the Watch It Again playlist on, like on YouTube, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Excuse me for just
a second. So, yeah. So, like, for the past, like, 6 months, like, all I've been listening to is just the same fucking, like, 5 albums.
Yeah. I didn't even really mention it, but, like, I've been listening to a ton of Primus recently, and I haven't even listened to a full album. Primus is awesome, but I have been listening to their greatest hits, like, nonstop.
Greatest hits? Wow.
I know. I haven't even listened to a full album yet.
Fuck, dude.
I know.
But yeah, like, all I've been listening to is just fucking Tool.
Yeah.
Mastodon. Deltron. Just all the same shit that I always listen to.
Have you been listening to, or have you been hearing about those rumors for the new Tool album?
Yeah.
Yeah, because we talked about it a little bit. Dude, those songs are getting longer and longer, and it sounds awesome.
Yeah, and they have enough material for 2 albums, but they only have 5 songs that they like right now.
Which is retarded.
And it's like, so, if all these songs are over 10 minutes long, then you could totally get away with putting out an album with 5 songs on it.
Yeah. I prefer quality over length, like, as long as they're good, who cares?
Well, it's like, 5 songs, like, that's, like, if they're over 10 minutes, that's, like, an hour long.
Yeah. Yeah. But I was telling you, like, what I want to happen is I want them to put out an album, and it's, like, 3 songs, but they're each, like, 25 minutes long.
Yeah.
I want Close to the Edge, but Tool.
Tools of Topographic Oceans.
Tools at the Edge, down by the river. Close to the Edge. And then he would talk about his wings.
Yeah. Like, that's the thing with Close to the Edge. Like, it's 1 18-minute song, then 2 9-minute songs. But, like, have you listened to Tales of Topographic Oceans?
Yeah.
Like that's more like what you're talking about with the 3 20-minute songs.
Well, it's what I want.
What I want.
It's all I want. Yeah, 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 yeah.
Hey, guys, you like Crazy Taxi?
I fucking love Crazy Taxi, actually.
Tactually.
Top of our game. Tactually. Fucking top of our game today. Holy shit. Getting distracted by everybody.
The toppest of the game.
I sent you the list, by the way, via text. You'll have to read some of those later, because, like, I remember most of these, but I don't remember some of them. But, what else? There's something I wanted to mention.
You sent it over text?
Yes.
Am I going to have to turn on data?
It should be just text. It did say multimedia message, so you might have to.
Yeah, hold on. Let me check it out.
Okay, well, you...
Something...
While you do that, I'm going to use the bathroom. I might have to grab my charger also.
Yeah. Oh, God. Whoa. My erection for Green Day never ends. Oh, what's your boat called? The Cunt Destroyer. Pops is basically Jesus. Brian, is that a vagina? Eric, no, it's a whiteboard. Brian, do you know who will be at lunch? Eric, Jesus, Gandhi, and shut up. Brian, did she just say that there's a dick for $12? Eric, where can you get a dick for $12? Do you need help? Call 1-800, I don't know. I just pictured you like full Super Saiyan hard on right there. A smelly home for the goofy. That's basically our dorm room. Florida? But that's America's Wang. They prefer the sunshine. That's a Simpsons reference. That's a Simpsons reference. Alec. Eric, this weekend will be the longest I'm gonna go without seeing you since we met. Eric, you might be so thirsty you might die. Alec, thirsty for a drink or thirsty for your dick? Thirsty! This one's talking about Asians. The aliens porn parody. Whoa. Space, no one here. Can you carry cream? Play that shit like Weird Al. Wine has legs. Is that a glory hole? It's a freedom hole, you son of a bitch. Excuse you carrying a little extra weight? It looks like you've got an extra chromosome. I don't want your Girl Scout cookies. I call it the ex-wife. Oh yeah? Well, I call it the ovary smasher. I woke up with a random cigarette burn on my body once. Probably because my dad put it out there. Did you know that if you put too much water in your mouth at once, you'll drown? I don't know that. My goldfish drowned the other day.
Okay, here we go.
Brian has a semen. A single semen.
A single semen. Man,
if you will.
Yeah. Have you just been...
me AIDS.
I don't remember the context for that one.
That looks like the kind of joint that you would shove in your urethra.
Yeah. Have you just been reading these off?
Yes.
All right, that's good. That's filled some airtime.
Get skewered straight to your ass. Is that a shish kebab or wobbly? I don't remember. Is there a level beyond pussy whipped?
Yeah. You good?
I had an abortion today. First thing I thought was skews. It was a magical day. Wait, you really had an abortion today? Yeah, three of them. Triplets.
Oh man. Yes.
Look.
Yes, Scoose is a buddy of ours. So we're all sitting at dinner yesterday. And what was it? What is it again? He said something along the lines of like, "Wait, you had an abortion today?" And I said, "Yeah, I had three." Oh no, he said like he said something about like, "Why would you think of me when you're getting an abortion?" That's what I said.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, whenever I get an abortion, I think about Scoose. I have three of them. And then Devin right next to us, a quiet kid, he's just like, yeah, you had triplets. Fuck Devin. God damn it.
That fucking, you stole. That was a Simpsons joke. The Sunshine State.
I did. I told them that too, and they're just like, no, it's going in.
No. It's a Simpsons joke, you fucking thief!
I told them that it was a Simpsons joke. They didn't listen to me. Because they... I don't know. Not my fault. Yeah. Alright, so... You want to talk about some release dates?
Let's talk about some release dates, yo.
Because we actually don't have a whole lot. I went searching over the last couple of weeks, and not a whole lot's been coming out.
Yeah.
But here's some stuff. We got Testament, Brotherhood of the Snake, out right now. Go listen to it. It's great.
Check it out.
we got Serpentine Dominion, which is a super band featuring the drummer from Black Dahlia Murder and Corpse Grinder from Cannibal Corpse. They're doing a little like grind, some little bit of mellow death stuff in there. Very good stuff.
Interesting.
I just downloaded it on Spotify. I thought it was coming out later today, or I'm sorry, later, like in like November, but good stuff.
Any other snake-themed albums?
No. We got a food-themed album, though.
Ooh.
We got Texas Toast, Chainsaw Massacre, and Smash Potato releasing Food Fight to their split that just came out of fucking nowhere.
Nice.
It was just out there one day. And I downloaded it immediately. It's good stuff. The whole thing is like a wrestling match, and the singer from Texas Toast is moderating. So the first half is a Texas Toast album, and the intro to that is, "Go God, fucking Texas Toast about to smash the place up." And then Smash Potato has their second half, and the dude from Texas Toast is like, "Oh, these fuckheads Smash Potato, they don't know how to do fucking anything right, but here they go." And then the ending is just, "Oh my god, Texas Toast fucking obliterated Smash Potato. I am so sorry. No refunds. It was so easy." good shit. Oh, there's also a cover of Tupac on there.
What?
They did a cover of California Love. They call it Chicago Love.
Yeah.
It's awesome. But yeah, Smash Potato, crossover thrash. Go check it out. It's amazing.
You know what that reminds me of?
What's that?
Remember Toxic Waste?
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Municipal Waste and Toxic Holocaust.
Yeah.
Remember how Toxic Holocaust fucking wrecked it and just made it grid?
Remember how Municipal Waste
fucking sucks? Yeah, I remember that.
No, they don't.
They're terrible. Trash heap.
What makes them different from anything else?
The fact that the singer's voice is terrible and that their riffs are boring.
Not bearable.
Fatal Not Feast was shit. Boring. Art of Partying had like two good songs on it.
You're just...
What?
You're just a closet Municipal Waste fan.
Oh yeah, everyone's a closet fan if they don't like it, right? Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
I'm right, but if I'm not right, I'm secretly right. Good job.
Yeah, just like you're also a closet Death Grips fan.
Death Grips fucking sucks, shut the fuck up. The Illies are fine. The Illies are good. But that's different.
Stop yelling in the museum.
Spiral to me, spiral me. What a good album.
You only like it because it doesn't have MC Ride on it.
I yeah, pretty much. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. Rap is terrible and everyone hates it.
It's barely even considered rap at this point.
That being said, I have been listening to a bunch of NWA recently. I don't know why.
Now the foot's on the other table.
Now the foot's in the other mouth.
Isn't good except for the stuff that I like.
We've got Lamb of God and a new EP called The Duke coming November 18th.
It's a good album title.
Yeah. Yep. We've got a really weird thing from Guar, a single called Black Friday coming out November 25th, and it's all cover tracks.
Does it have Black Friday on it?
No.
What the fuck?
It's only got like four songs on it.
What are they?
I didn't even look at the song list. I did look at it, and it's like Pet Shop Boys and a bunch of weird bands that they're gonna do.
Oh.
So, like I guess. What? I guess I'm happy that there's new Guar stuff, but...
I mean, that they put Black Friday on it if it's the name.
I don't know.
Don't they want to paint the devil on the wall?
Well, the thing is that, like, Guar always wants to do stupid songs. Like, they did the cover of, Carry On My Wayward Son.
Wow, you hating on fucking Kansas? Wow.
No. I'm not saying that they do stupid songs, but they want to do non-traditional songs, like stuff that you wouldn't expect.
Yeah.
That's what I meant.
Yeah.
It's a great cover. It's a great song. carry on, my no good, dirty, rotten bastard of a son.
Fucking.
It's fucking awesome.
Doc Barrett, he fucking vehemently hates Carry On, My Wayward Son, and I don't understand why.
That's just, he's not a good human being at that point. He's not a human being at that point. You don't like Carry On, My Wayward Son. That's classic. It's such a good song. How could he hate it?
Don't know.
Well, guess what? I hate him now.
Don't be rude. He's gonna listen to this. He's gonna type like an essay in the comments.
Hey, if you're listening to this, please shut the fuck up. Your comments are not necessary. I will just block you. That's fine. I can ban you from subscribing.
I'll unban him.
I'll reban him. We'll be in an eternal banning war.
Power.
Do you, though? Oh, yeah, that's right. You do.
Yeah. I go in and I fix your spelling errors in the titles.
Shut up. It's fine. Spelling is not my strong suit. I'm a computer engineer. That means I'm good at math. Not much else.
You have to, like, type code?
It's a long story, but I'm changing my major. But, yes, I do. I type code. But the thing is, you don't have to type code. You just have to type consistently. I'm sorry, you don't have to type correctly. You have to type consistently.
What does that mean?
It means if I have a variable name and it's something like, I don't know, diarrhea, it means I don't have to spell diarrhea correctly. I have to spell it whatever I spell it throughout the entire line of code. So if my variable is literally diarrhea, it's diarrhea plus ass. I can spell diarrhea any name I want, and then I just have to auto type it later. And because I have autocorrect and, you know, autofix in my program, I can type it one way and then just type a letter and then hit enter and it fills it for me.
Nice.
I don't have to be a good speller. It's fine. Why are you making fun of my disability, Dakota?
Because
that's not nice. You're gonna have all of the Tumblr arenas down on your throat. You're being ableist. You're being like an ableist fuck right now. Stop it.
You know, before I actually like heard the term, like I thought it was pronounced ableist, and I didn't get it.
Yeah.
Like what does this have to do with disability? Oh, able.
Oh.
Oh!
Yeah, like Abel from Street Fighter. Oh.
Yeah.
But Abel's cool, though, so why would you hate him?
Because he's the feet strider.
Yeah, you're right.
Man, I wish I could be into fighting games.
You just have to buy them. You have to play them.
Maybe
think about getting a fight stick. But
the only thing, the only game I've been playing recently is Sanren Kagura.
You hear that? That's all like the life just leaving my body.
You want to play it too.
Shut up. Don't worry about that.
There's a girl in there that's fucking Jotaro with titties.
Yeah, it's Titty Jotaro. She's the coolest. She's
fucking awesome.
She's so cool looking.
There's also a girl. It's just fucking guts.
What?
Yeah. Like, she doesn't look like guts.
So?
But what? She has a fucking giant-ass sword.
Oh.
And a crossbow mounted on her arm.
What? I'm
Googling this right now. Hello?
I said I'm Googling this right now.
Oh, let me get you. Her name is Yomi.
I'm looking at it right now, and you're right. Oh my god. Okay.
I can't believe Jake fucking died.
Full on eye contact. Jesus Christ. Can't get any work done in this place. Yeah, that's right. I'm working. Don't worry about it.
So, yeah, anyways.
Yeah. What?
I really recommend it, though. Like, it's actually legitimately quite fun.
I am not looking at porn right now, Jake.
I know, you're broadcasting.
I'm broadcasting porn, correct. Nothing but fun over here.
Yeah.
They make a lot of money. I know, right? Fun fact, I know a girl that does that.
My ex did that.
Oh. Yeah.
Yeah. And I know,
what a time to be alive.
That actually went into the porn industry.
What a time to be alive. Okay, where the fuck was I? Everyone's distracting me. Okay,
talking about Senrons.
Right, I was talking to you, and I was telling you, you're a gigantic weeaboo for liking Senran Kagura.
You want to play it, too. You told me. That, yeah, I wanted to play this, too.
Yeah.
Get around to it.
Yeah. But here's the thing. Because I called you a weeaboo first, that means you're still more of a weeaboo than I am.
I mean, that's undeniable at this point.
Yeah.
But you're still just a pot calling the kettle black.
Well, how about this? I didn't like Drifter.
What?
It's overrated.
Okay. Okay, listen.
Yeah? Listen. What?
You're gonna have to explain yourself here.
Because it's Helsing for weeaboos.
What does that mean?
It means that it's ultraviolet.
Helsing is an anime.
What? Helsing is an anime.
Yes.
Listen to what the fuck you're saying. How is it not?
For weeaboos.
How is it not? You answer my question. How is Helsing not anime?
It is an anime.
Well, then what the fuck did you call it not an anime for?
I didn't say that. I said Helsing is an anime.
Oh, yes, correct.
So, by default, it is for weeaboos.
Not all animes for fucking weeaboos. There's some that's just straight up weeaboo bait.
Helsing isn't, like, some normie-ass, like, Toonami anime.
And what exactly is normie-ass Toonami anime?
Like, shit like Dragon Ball or Naruto.
So... Well, wait, hold on. JoJo was on Toonami.
Yeah, and it's like, have you seen the fucking comments?
I have seen those comments. All those people calling Dio Donald Trump, dude, that is fucked up.
Television makes me want to be dead.
Same, same.
Oh, God. The JoJo fandom... It's just been getting worse worse.
It
ever
really
since
has.
Crunchyroll got its hands on it.
It really has been like overrun by normies. Like the word normies is fucking stupid and I hate it, but it's apropos.
It's like all these fucking retards.
They don't understand
about. Stupid shit.
They don't understand my giant greasy man fight anime. Why don't they?
What? These fucking people.
Shut up, Jake. It's JoJo.
Haman isn't coming back.
No.
You fucking children.
It's not even coming back in the reset universe.
It's... Haman is shit.
Haman is shit compared to Stans. You're right.
Read the fucking manga.
Yeah, for real.
Do yourself a favor. Good human being.
we should go out of our way to like spoil things for people who haven't watched the manga. I'm sorry,
watched the manga?
Shut up. We just stared at the manga waiting for it to change. We should spoil it for people who haven't read the... Shut up, Jake! I'm trying to work here. We should spoil it for people who haven't read the manga.
Yeah.
Just straight up spoil the ending of part 4.
Yeah. Did you know that at the end of part 4...
fucking dies?
Yeah. Did you know that Okuyasu fucks Koichi in the parking lot behind Subway?
I remember that vividly.
Looking back, that was pretty fucked up, wasn't it?
It was like 6 pages long, too. It was really graphic. That'll probably be a two-parter when we get around to it.
Yeah.
And then you do the thing where, like, the outro plays over the what's going on, and you just hear, ooh, I want you and knew if I need.
I had a thought. Okay.
Yeah?
Yuya Fungami.
Who?
He's pretty much a foot fetishist, isn't he?
Who?
Highway Star.
Oh. Yeah, he is, isn't he?
Think about it.
I forgot about that part. I'm sure even when I was reading the manga, I was like, yeah, that's not correct.
You got me sidetracked, by the way. You diverted the question.
No, I didn't. Shut up.
What's wrong with Drifters?
Oh, yeah. Drifters is lame.
Why is it lame? It's fucking awesome.
Because it's really, like, standard action that I've seen a bunch of times with a bunch of, like, samurai shit that I've seen a bunch of times.
Okay, but it's by fucking Kota Hirano.
So?
Listen, just give me my edgy, gory bullshit, okay?
You want edgy, gory bullshit? Go watch Spawn.
No.
Why?
I don't know what that is.
The Spawn cartoon from HBO?
Is.
Have you never heard of Spawn ever?
I've heard of Spawn. I don't know what it's about.
Spawn
I know
is amazing.
It's an Iced Earth album about Spawn.
Are you fucking for real right now?
Yes, that is real.
Hold on a sec. I'm Googling that one.
I'm not even joking. This is accurate.
This can't be right. I refuse to believe this. Oh my god.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Iced Earth, The Dark Saga.
Oh my god.
An entire concept album about fucking Spawn.
I don't know how to feel about this.
So what the fuck does Spawn even do? What's his powers?
He's a man who is basically Satan's bounty hunter. And he has to collect souls for Satan.
That sounds cool.
It's cool as shit. And Todd McFarlane's art is actually super cool.
So why do people shit on it all the time, then?
Because it got real edgy real fast. It's why 90s comics are considered to be, like, the edgy Dark Lord era.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But, like, here's the question. Is it, like, on the scale, how edgy is it?
It leans towards self-parody near the end, kind of like Reaper from to Overwatch.
Yeah.
But it's still very solid and well done.
Yeah.
It doesn't take itself as seriously and as entertainingly as, say, Preacher, which is super edgy but also really dark and can hold itself up.
Yeah.
So, I don't know. I haven't read a whole ton of the comics, but I got through, like, the first volume and it's very solid.
So, I have this theorem.
Mm-hmm.
This is something that I call the Uncanny Valley of Edge.
Okay.
So, as a series or just a work of art gets darker, there's more of a perceived goodness to it. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I think I know what you're talking about.
But at a certain point, we get to this point where it becomes too edgy.
It becomes self-parody.
Yeah, it becomes edgy to the point where it's, like, almost humorous.
Mm-hmm.
And this is what I call the Uncanny Valley. Because it's half-assed edge.
Yeah. You know?
It's the shit like Shadow the Hedgehog, or like Sasuke from Naruto.
Now, here's the thing, though. Shadow the Hedgehog and Sasuke are awesome.
Are you gonna say that legitimately?
Yeah. Why wouldn't I? Do you think I'm not being serious?
I mean, you did like Suicide Squad.
Listen, Suicide Squad
was a major topic in last podcast.
It is a 5 out of 10 movie at best, and I like it.
But anyways, the
fucking
point
Killer
is,
Croc's voice shook the theater. It was awesome.
Everything you think about that you would say is typically super edgy, I would consider to be half-assed Edge, because it takes itself too seriously.
Yeah.
You know? Like...
It goes from being serious and dramatic to being melodramatic.
Yeah. And, like, there are ways to get around... To be, like... To be super serious, but also... Like, be super edgy and be good at it.
Uh-huh.
But, Dark. Again, that's because they're just being more serious.
Dark and serious subject matter is a thing that can happen.
Yeah.
Like, I'm reading Preacher right now. That shit is insane.
Like, so... You get stuff like, just the shitty, edgy stuff everyone talks about, everyone makes fun of. But once you go edgier than that... Then it starts getting fucking great.
Mm-hmm.
Then you start getting shit like Berserk, which is absurdly dark and absurdly serious, but it works because it's fucking nuts.
So it becomes awesome. It becomes so edgy that it surpasses its own edginess.
Yes. Or shit that doesn't take itself seriously at all. And absolutely revels in its own edginess. Right. Shit like Helsing.
Helsing definitely does that.
That's why I say that. Because, like, Helsing... There are scenes in Helsing where the streets of London are being flooded by rivers of corpses.
Yep.
That is the fucking edgy shit! And it's fucking awesome, dude.
Helsing is great.
That's why Drifters is getting very promising.
Now, here's the thing, though.
Because Drifters. It's made by the same guy,
Drifters,
and it's following the same patterns.
Drifters is not cool, though, because it's an aesthetic thing. It's not necessarily its own edginess. It's stuff I just don't like. Samurais are boring.
What? Okay.
Uh-huh.
Okay, yeah. this is bad opinions hour.
Shut up.
With Eric McLean.
Oh yeah, I bad opinions hour. Jake, it's bad opinions hour. Did you hear that?
I bet you like fucking medieval shit.
I don't like medieval shit. That's also
you like
boring.
Lord of the Rings, don't you?
I hate Lord of the Rings. I've never seen Lord of the Rings actually. I like sci-fi shit. Speaking of which, Jake.
Samurais are cool.
When are we gonna get sci-fi Dark Souls?
As soon as I can.
As soon as he can make it. When are we going to get sci-fi Dark Souls, Dakota? When are we going to get it?
Whenever you want.
I want it now. I want it now.
When are you going to get Samurai Dark Souls? Oh, wait, that exists. It's called Neo.
I know, Neo sounds awesome.
But you hate Neo. Samurai because you have shit opinions.
It's the Samurai Dark Souls I told you about. You can download the beta on your PS4. Yeah.
I could also download Destroy All Humans on my PS4.
Yes, you can. You should. $20. Did you hear about that, Dakota? You can download Destroy All Humans right now.
On PS4?
On PS4.
What?
Or, you know, just get the ISO.
Ruining this commercial. Fuck you.
Listen. Buy Destroy All Humans. Do it. Everybody.
I don't even... is that even good?
It's defined good.
Is it?
The game's stupid, but it's great. It's hilariously bad. Well,
you know, I've had a PS2 since like the day it came out. Like, I have a 15-year-old console, and I have jack shit for games on it.
Then get Destroy All Humans 2. And,
There are so many classic games for the PS2 that I've never played, like Ico or Shadow of the Colossus.
Or Devil May Cry.
Devil May Cry, yeah.
Might. What the fuck were we talking about?
We were talking about...
Shut up.
We were talking about Drifters, then we got sidetracked on JoJo, then we bit back to Drifters, then we started talking about on. And then listen. I went into my whole theorem about edginess.
Uh-huh. So, have you heard about the new Metallica album?
I've heard of it. I've Hardwired, heard songs from it.
Hardwired to Self-Destruct, November 18th.
Yeah. The Moth Into Shut the up, Flame Jake. Is the only song so far that I've heard that I kind of like.
Moth Into the Flame is solid. I like it.
It's an okay song. It's at least I remember how the chorus goes. I remember nothing about the self title about the title track.
Yeah, it was kind of nothing. But I'm gonna listen to it because I'm a fucking whore.
When does it come out?
November 18th.
We're still on fucking release dates, aren't we?
Yeah.
let's rush through that lightning round, and then we can get to like actual news.
That was the last one.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
What's actual news then?
Actual news. What do we got? Looking at the list. We've got the news that put me on suicide watch a couple weeks ago.
What?
Overkill's grinding wheel has been pushed to 2017.
I'm fine with that.
I am not fine with that in the slightest. Give it to me now.
It's okay.
It was supposed to be out this week, this month. And then it got pushed to November.
It's like, alright. It's fine.
Shut up.
It's fine.
If it gets pushed one more time, I will. I now understand why those people got upset at Mighty Number 9.
People got upset at Mighty Number 9 because it was fucking shit.
It was fucking shit, wasn't it? But listen, Overkill's not. So, ixo fatso, I win. What?
What? It's gonna be a good album. Doesn't matter that it's gonna be delayed. I'm fine with waiting.
No, I don't want to wait though. Is my problem. My problem is that they put the goalpost in front of me, and then they move that goalpost, and then they move that goalpost again, and it's now in like a different city.
You got a car, you can drive.
Yeah, but I don't want to drive all that way.
I don't even know what that means in this metaphor.
It means I'm traveling through time. You can't travel through time, Dakota. Not yet, anyway.
Try. Just freeze yourself.
I'd make like Futurama. 3,000 years later. Is the new Lich King album out yet? No. Son of a bitch. Go 1,000 years again.
You got Robot Tom and Robot Brian.
Oh my god, Robot Tom and Brian would be awesome.
And they just have a Twitter post that just says, no. Yeah, we're about halfway done with the new album.
Those fucking liars. They just put up like a tweet the other day that was like, hey, we're in the middle of recording the album. And I'm like, you fucking liars. I don't believe you for a second. You're the biggest procrastinators in all of music. Next to Tool.
Wow.
I'm a little salty, but like I know it's going to be worth the wait. Lich King 5, it's happening.
Lich King 5, stalemate.
It's probably going to be stalemate.
Yeah. Didn't in one of their podcasts they say like, that's actually not going to be the name of the album or something.
Yes. No. It was Tom who said, it was someone brought it up like, oh, and the album's probably going to be called Stalemate. And then Tom was like, no, it's not. It's like, yeah, but the song that you put out was called Lich King 5 Stalemate. And it's like, yeah, well, I could change it. He was just being a dick for no reason.
Because
of course Tom would do that. Tom is the biggest shitlord. I love him so much. Like, and he's still singing on the album, as far as we know.
Would you fuck him?
Would I? The question is, when I?
Yeah.
When would I do that? The second he called. Let's move on.
Yeah.
Hey, so you know how Slayer is kind of terrible without Gary Holt?
Yeah.
Well, Kerry King says, hey, Gary Holt can contribute on the next album.
Yeah.
Well,
I saw that.
That fixes everything that was wrong with Repentless.
Yeah.
Everything. The only problem with Repentless was that it was obvious that Kerry King wrote everything.
Like, hey, maybe if you ignored your fucking ego for 1 second, you could have put out a good album.
Repentless wasn't that bad. It wasn't Book of Souls bad.
It wasn't Book of Souls bad, but it was still pretty fucking mediocre.
Now, hold on, quick question. Which is better, the new Slayer album or the new Megadeth album?
Because
I'm sticking with the Slayer album. I did not care for Dystopia.
I didn't like the new Megadeth album, but I will have to give it to them anyways.
Why?
Because it was shit, but it was better than, the last two albums.
Wait, Dakota, are you telling me that you didn't like Super Collider?
I did. We have said this for, 7,000 eons.
But Super Collider has songs like Dance in the Rain.
I did not enjoy Super Collider.
And The Blackest Crow.
I did not like it, Sam I Am.
And also,
13 fucking blow, too.
Kingmaker. And also, Super Collider.
More like Pooper Collider.
Wow. I think that was probably the best joke you have ever made.
Yeah. Subscribe for more content.
For more jokes, TM. Yeah.
Adding the TM symbol at the end of, random words is, one of my favorite new types of humor.
Because, yeah, I own this joke.
Yeah.
Super Collider TM. Twice as funny.
Yeah.
It's like a joke multiplier.
It's free humor. You just tack it on, and immediately you know, oh, wait, this isn't real. This is just jokes.
Tis a joke, TM.
Yeah. You could say, hey, I want to whip out my dick.
And that dick has TM on it.
People would be like, wow, that's kind of weird. But then you can say, I'm going to whip out my dick, TM. And then it'll be like, I know what you mean.
You'd be surprised at how many times I've heard the phrase, I'm going to whip my dick out around here.
How many times has it actually happened, though?
Right before I sat down, someone was like, oh, can I show him my dick?
Before we started recording?
Yes. I was just about to turn everything on, get everything set up, and then I think it was Alec. He's like, what are you doing? I'm like, oh, I'm gonna have a conversation on Skype. And he goes, oh, can I show him my dick? Yep.
Nice.
And we got a fun group in this little box that we call a hellhole. Yes, we are obsessed with dicks. I don't know why. Dicks aren't even cool.
I mean, I like mine.
I mean, yeah. You know, dicks are like farts. You know, you like your own, but everyone else is just fucking pisses you off. Get that dick out of my face. Just, no.
Are their dicks live on stream?
No, they're not live on stream.
Live on recording?
No. All the dicks are just out.
Is there a dick in front of you right now?
Is it too late to say dicks out for Harambe?
It is too late. Fuck you.
Dude, we've been keeping that joke going, though. All like six of us in our group.
No. No.
Richard is out.
Let it fucking die.
Richard is out for Harambo.
It's not funny anymore.
No, it's funny.
It stopped being funny 2 months ago.
Too bad. We're all dressing up as bananas for Halloween, by the way.
It's dead, Eric. It's dead.
No, stop. He's already dead.
Why? God.
What is news?
And now it's time for. And now it's time for. I can't believe they aren't already in there.
What?
We're talking about whatchamacalls. The fuck.
Hall of Fame?
Yes, the inductees for the Hall of Fame.
What do we got?
We've got people such as the Bad Brains. Should already be in there. Fuck you, the punk band.
That's exactly why. Fucking who?
Get shit on. We've got Electric Light Orchestra.
What do they do?
Mr. Blue Sky and Evil Woman.
Like,
fuck you, they're awesome. Space Rock.
Okay, I believe you.
We got James Addiction.
I've heard Electric Light Orchestra's name revered in times.
I posted them on Tumblr at one point.
So who else?
We got Jane's Addiction.
I've heard that name before.
Now who the one you will really recognize? Pearl Jam.
What the fuck?
Green Day and Michael Jackson got into the Hall of Fame before fucking Pearl Jam.
Isn't there like a limit though, or like a time limit or something?
It's like. You have to be a band for a certain number of years.
Like, isn't it like 20 years or something?
Your first single has to be out for like 20 years, I think. But that's just it. Why did Green Day get it first? Because Pearl Jam was still at least like late-ish 80s.
Huh.
Followed by Journey. I like Journey.
I thought they were already in.
I also thought they were already in.
That's quite bizarre.
Followed by The Cars.
Man.
I know, right?
Man, I can't listen to music anymore.
I know. It's all go back home, everybody. Music is dead. Here's a weird one. Tupac is getting in.
Yeah, I can believe that.
I guess. I don't fucking know. And the one that will actually put you on suicide watch. Yes.
Oh, fuck.
Why?
How did it take that long?
Is Pink Floyd even in at this point? I don't even know anymore.
They gotta be.
They have to be.
They're
I mean, if we're
they're
going
way too in the realm of normie rock.
Is that what we're calling it now? Normie rock?
Yeah.
I bet they don't even like The Wall.
I went there.
It's better than
I Dark Side. There. There's literally, like on the top floor of the Hall of Fame, there's, like, a giant The Wall wall.
It's the big wall, and it's got some of the monsters from the movie.
Yeah, and it's got, like,
it's cool as shit.
The Roger Waters quotes.
Yeah.
I mean, The Wall isn't even the best Pink Floyd album, though.
I mean, it is, and you're wrong, but...
It's... I mean, Wish You Were Here is better. Barrett, if you're in the comments, back me up on this.
No, if you're in the comments, please don't do that. In fact, back me up and tell me I'm right.
No.
Just change
sides. Anyone in the comments.
Just be a total scrub and change sides.
Do you get comments? Be a heel.
I don't fucking know. I don't read them.
Doesn't it notify you when there's comments?
I think so, but this YouTube channel's been dead for like, what, six years?
It's been dead since the start.
It crawled out of the ground as a corpse.
Yeah, it's a zombie.
It's a cannibal corpse.
Oh! I remember, like, on the last day of high school, we had, like, a discussion about the concept of a cannibal corpse. I don't know why that stuck with me.
Well, because you never actually think about it. Because you think cannibal corpse, it's almost self-explanatory, but then you think about it too long.
It's a zombie that eats other zombies. Well, you're fucking right. It's just like Helsing. Except it's of the zombies instead of vampires.
Sure, eating, let's go with that.
Instead of killing, it's eating.
And yeah, except it's better than Drifters.
Yeah, fuck you.
Drifters is lame.
Drifters, you just don't like samurai because you have bad opinions.
Samurais are fucking stupid.
You got, they're
what
cool.
Do they ever do for me?
Why are you hating on the Nippons?
You really, really have a problem with your weeaboo shit. I'm here to stop you. This is actually an intervention. Stop doing your Nico Nico knee. Stop it.
No.
No, stop doing the Nico Nico knee.
She's not even the best girl in Love Live.
Stop watching Love Live, goddammit. I think you're actually crying right now. What's your problem? He's just like, no, leave me and my weeaboo shit alone. We didn't do nothing.
I just want to play titty games.
Yeah, you did make a mistake. You were born. getting a little too real up in here.
Fuck.
Yeah, I know.
So, what other nudie news is there?
Guar is putting together a Kickstarter for a comic called Orgasmageddon.
Are you gonna fund it?
I'm
entirely
gonna look
right by now. Yourself.
As much as I would actually love to, because I love Guar and comics. Yeah, where was I? Yeah, Guar has like enough of a crazy ass fan base that they will get it funded almost immediately.
Nice.
Yeah, I'm looking at it right now. It's got 28 more days to go, and it's got 27,000 of 39,000 that it needs.
Oh yeah, there's no way they won't get it.
Yeah, no. Guar's fan base is fucking weird and stupid and crazy. But I'm thinking about it, like I'm staring at it. If I didn't just buy a whole bunch of shit and feel like I have no money, I probably would fund it. I'm looking at some of the backer rewards that they got. It does look super cool. The highest one is... you get a stage prop, the one that they use on stage, for $1,700. It's of Mitt Romney's head.
Nice.
Very cool.
It's fucking outdated shit.
I know.
Who gives a fuck about Mitt Romney?
I don't know. Mittens. And the highest one that's actually been taken is $1,500. Another stage use prop. It's Bin Laden's skull.
Fucking so outdated.
I don't care. It's cool as shit.
Who gives a shit about Al-Qaeda anymore?
Yeah,
ISIS
who gives a shit?
ISIS is the hot new shit.
Yeah, that's right. ISIS is the hot new terrorist group. Who cares about Al-Qaeda anymore?
Fucking old fags.
For $1,000, I can be in issue one and get killed by Guar.
Nice.
That's actually super cool. Oh, there's a baby Gorgor statue. And it glows in the dark. Where can I get that one? I want it.
I want it.
I want it bad.
I need it. I want it.
I want you all tattooed.
I want it. I need it. Need it to make
for like feel. For like $375, you can get tattoos of the various members by an artist, like a professional artist. That's
weird. Can it, that's weird. Can it, you just get that anyways?
I don't know. But it's for the thing of like, I want this made by an actual artist.
The like... oh, that's weird.
But I'm for sure reading this the second it comes out. It looks so fantastic. It's going to be outdated as shit, though, within a couple of days. Because, yeah, here's the one I'm looking at right now. There's a panel where one of the guys, I think it's Blothar, is at a Trump rally. And he's like, he's using his weird udders to, like, spray the crowd.
Yeah.
His tagline is, my milkshake brings all the boys to the yard.
Nice.
It's, what is going on? I love this comic already.
Guar is neat. Sometimes I feel like they're too invested in current events.
Yeah.
Like, because current events just fucking dates you so hard.
Like, I remember watching one of their stage shows on YouTube, and they brought out like a big plastic mannequin of Justin Bieber, and they were like decapitating it, and I'm like, wow.
Yeah, nobody's gonna give a shit about that in like 4 years.
Like a week, more like it.
Yeah. Well, was it that already at that point where Justin Bieber started becoming not popular?
Don't worry about it.
Yeah, pretty much.
My microphone speaker is shit, so I use a microphone whenever I have to talk.
What are you talking
to? I'm talking to my laptop. What the fuck do you think I'm talking to?
I'm talking to the ghost of the machine.
I'm not actually talking to my laptop, Brian. Chill out.
What's going on in here?
What's going on in here? Breakfast.
Who are you talking to?
I'm talking to a friend of mine back home.
Shut up! Have some respect.
I don't. That's why I'm here.
Same. Well, now you've met Brian.
Yeah. Yeah, now you've met Brian, the loud asshole at my dorm.
I am Brian!
Yeah, good job, Brian. You know your name.
Hello, I'm the laptop.
He introduced himself as a laptop.
Good job. Okay, so we should wrap this shit up.
Wrap it up.
Mm-hmm. What a productive day we've had. We've bitched about Drifters and how terrible it is.
And how it's fucking awesome.
It's not cool.
Speaking of...
What?
Have you seen Keijo yet?
Oh my god. No.
Okay.
But it's saved it under my Kiss anime, and I don't know if I want to go down that road.
It's fucking awesome.
Yeah, but my problem is I watch a lot of dumb, ecchi animes already.
So okay,
do I have room for another
consider
one?
Consider this. It's basically Hajime no Ippo.
No, shut up. It's not.
It is.
Shut the fuck up.
It's a sports anime.
Fuck you.
It's fucking rad.
In that case, Rocky is the Hajime no Ippo of fucking movies.
Listen.
What?
The main character accidentally comes up with a well-established technique called butt cannon.
This is an anime about butt battles. Shut up.
It's the vacuum butt cannon is basically the same thing as a Dempsey roll.
That's stupid. No, I don't like this.
No, because listen, it's an extremely powerful attack that, like, the main character came up with the on the spot on accident, and they just didn't know that it was an already existing move. And also, it takes a toll on, like, the user's body, because, like, it's such an unnatural move. Like, remember how Ippo basically, like, got told, hey, you should stop using the Dempsey roll, because it's fucking up your body.
Okay, so I never finished Ippo?
I get what you're saying.
I'm just saying, I get what you're saying, though. That trope has been in a lot of animes.
Yeah.
But listen to yourself, Dakota. This is an anime about girls using their butts to fight.
Listen.
What? How am I... Go ahead, Dakota. How am I in the wrong this time?
In the most recent episode, one of the characters fucking uses the world.
Shut up. No. I can't... No.
It's a battle of speed. They're competing to see who is the fastest Keijo player in Western Japan. And, like, the one opponent is really tough, really fucking fast, and the secondary main character girl can't beat her. But then she uses her secret technique where she gives herself a wedgie in order to put less constraint on her butt, which allows her to move like 10 times faster. And
that's
the effect
not how
they
the
use
world works.
No, but the effect they use is basically like she just teleports instantly. She's so fucking fast.
This anime is retarded.
It's fucking radical.
I don't know how to feel anymore. Anime has ruined me.
Awesome!
Anime's ruined everything.
It's great.
Who was the guy that made Spirited Away?
There are ass auras!
Miyazaki? Miyazaki was right. Anime was a mistake.
No, it's great.
Anime's a giant fucking problem.
So fun.
Okay, so why does everyone hate it when I watch things like Mazo Gokin HXH and it's all creepy and weird if I watch it, but all of a sudden the butt battle anime comes out and everyone loves it?
Because it's fucking awesome, dude.
Shut up. Mazen Goku HXH was great.
People are doing, like, attack rushes.
Oh my god.
Like, the auras and the mudas.
Are you for real?
With their asses. I will show you a gif.
I can't deal with this. I can't do it right now. No.
Listen. I don't think you understand how fucking rad this is.
I think I understand that you're a goddamn weeaboo.
I am, but
yeah,
that's irrelevant. There's titty hypnotization.
I saw that gif. That was stupid.
Oh, God, where is it? I gotta find it.
I can't do this anymore.
Gotta find it.
I don't think I can watch anime anymore.
Remember when that one girl was massaging the other girl's ass and it was like, now I've got your power. Did you see that?
Yeah. Jesus Christ. The context for that is? Why'd you bring that up?
Because. Okay, I found the gif. Let me link it to you. Okay, check this shit out.
Oh my god!
Yeah!
Oh my god! I can't right now. I can't.
Dude, it's super cool!
No, I can't deal with this right now. This fucking butt battle anime looks cool. There's like 8 goddesses in South Korea. I can't handle this shit anymore. Life is dumb.
Oh yeah!
That is no.
8 goddesses! Of that South Korea.
That can't be
this
real.
This fucking real life anime plot.
No, it's not.
Happening right now.
No, it's not. Shut up. It's not real. I refuse to believe it. It's not happening. It's not real. It's fine.
It's real.
No. I don't want it to be.
Oh, God.
Are we done yet? I want to be done.
Probably.
Okay. So, one last thing. We got cool guys of the week.
Cool guys? Who's the cool guys?
So, I met a friend up here. His name's Scoose, and he plays bass, and he is a bassist for a band called Declension. And they are a sick-ass death metal band.
Okay.
They're cool as shit, so enjoy their song Empty Bottles.
Link me that shit.
Hold on just a second. Quick, do something. Fill dead air.
So Drifters is fucking awesome.
Okay, cut that shit out. That's not funny.
Keijo's fucking awesome.
Keijo
is lame. The season is pretty good. Not gonna lie. They've got some good shit coming out this season.
How about that One Punch Man season 2?
Yeah, when is it? Fall 2017? I mean, or is it spring?
I don't know.
I think it's spring 2017.
Did you watch Mob Psycho 101?
It's 100, and I actually haven't. I need to get around to that.
It's super good.
Did you finish it?
I did. It's honestly better than One Punch Man. Son of a whore.
I can believe that. It seems like it would be believable.
I mean, shit.
I mean,
it works better. You good, Jake?
No, salty.
Oh, he's super salt. It works better as a...
I want to play this game.
One Punch Man works better as a comedy. That's what I'm trying to say, first of all. And this works better as more of a serious anime. That's all.
Alright, can see that. Makes sense.
Yeah. And honestly, like, some of the joke... You know how One Punch Man has those frames where the just the style just changes dramatically?
Yeah. It's the original one style.
No. It's every single frame of this anime is in something different style. It's so bizarre and just it doesn't stop for a second. It's great. Holy shit, what am I looking at? No.
That's the fight from the most recent episode.
No. This is dumb. I don't like it.
You know, if you think about it, the world really would have to be super speed and not just, like...
Time stop?
Yeah, because if it was, like, completely stopped time, then some of the shit just wouldn't work. Like, first of all, Dio wouldn't even be able to see, because if time is stopped, then light would not move. So everything would just be dark.
Dakota.
And also, the fact that... He can throw knives, and they have momentum, and then they slowly stop.
Dakota.
What?
Stop trying to make JoJo logical.
It's good.
There's a stand where when you open things, it shows up. Shut up.
Yeah.
Rock, it's paper, cool. Scissors is a stand.
Yeah! It's cool!
Your stand can only activate when you die.
Yeah!
There's one that can turn your blood into razor blades. It's cool as shit.
Metallica is the fucking coolest stand in Part 5.
It is. It really is. Except King Crimson's cooler. It punches you once.
That's so? All it has to do. The world can... Any punch ghost stand can punch you once.
Yes, but King Crimson doesn't have to. It can punch once. It only has to punch once.
Yeah.
The world doesn't.
The world fucking made a donut out of Kakyoin.
It made a donut out of the clock tower.
Yeah.
I don't have time for this. Do you have another secret on your stand? Yes, your stand can stop time. Yeah. Stop time.
Totally not.
Totally can't. Breathe fire. Breathe fire. Right? No. Oh, thank God. Are we good here?
I think we're good.
All right, Jamcast is over. Bye.
See ya.
Too much to bear. I can't stand to face the fact that my life's gone.